Hello friends, today in this tutorial we are going to learn how to draw an onion. Onion is somewhat spherical object. It has two ends, conical ends. Okay, just like for example, this is the conical end. This is the conical edge. Okay, and it has roundity, just like a sphere. As a compressed sphere, okay, and it has segments all along its profile going like this. So the geometry is extremely important while drawing this onion. One can observe it has a tilted axis and it is rested on ground. It has tilted axis and we have to draw everything along this axis. This is the axis. It's axis. If it's tilted, the axis goes like this. Okay. So this is the axis and we'll first draw its axis. And its horizontal axis. To take measurement, I will use this pencil. This is measurement. Its total height, okay, like this. And its horizontal axis. Approximately, just like this. So these are the approximately dimension of this sphere, height and width. Okay. So this is the way I'm going to draw it. This is approximate dimension. Now we'll make some more detail into that, as this has its mountain and stop. This is approximate shape. Okay, and now we move towards more detail. It has certain highlight over this area, so approximately we'll mark it. It's along its horizontal axis. This is the highlighted area as per this area, and these are its detail. Onion has certain property, its pill has some sharp cut. It is the material property of its object. So we have to render all these edges very sharply and very finely. So at the beginning I am marking those areas where I have to make it sharp cut. Now we'll see the metal I am going to use for this tutorial. In this tutorial I am using Bristow 200 GSM paper and pencils like 3B, 8B, 3B, 8B and 10B as well for its darker shade, and for lighter shade I may use 2H. And the needed eraser which will be used for creating these fine lines, light lines, okay, after shading and the final touches. When I will be giving final touches, I will use kneaded eraser. So let us start its rendering process. First I will use pencil 10B to mark the darkest areas. My method is this: first apply the darkest tone in the object such that it gives me an idea of applying lighter tones as well and how much lighter it should be. Once I have applied darkest tone, it definitely gives how much darker should I give, how much darker tones I should apply on every places on this object. First I am marking these darker tones with extreme sharp 10B pencil. This sharp cut as well. Now I will use pencil 8B. To make a shade. You can see these are the lines, so I'm leaving that line here. At the same time, I'm marking some line here as well. Approximately lines I am marking. Now I am applying shade with the help of 8B pencil. Now we'll check the exact tone we need to apply at this layer. We'll compare this tone with the use of grayscale. It should be almost this much darker. So I'm applying TNB as well. Yeah, it's almost like that. Little bit darker it needs. Now it's a little gradient from this end to this end, dark to light. So I am merging the stone to light area. Here I am applying layer over layer, but I am not applying any pressure on that. A little pressure. Again I am sharpening this pencil 10B. So for this area I will use a 8B pencil, a little lighter one. I am applying one more layer of graphite of a pencil 8B over it. Now I am going to mark this area. This is a fold, okay, with the help of 10B pencil. This is merging towards upper side. For rendering this part, I need to make its 10B extremely sharp. I am leaving this space empty just to give a feel of lifted feel. Now watch it carefully. I am magnifying, zooming in the picture. Here it is a fine vein, you can see. How I am going to render that, okay? For this purpose I have used very extremely sharp pencil. I have left that vein lighter and surrounding it a plaid graphite. Here also I have to leave this white vein. Here as well, I have to apply extreme dark graphite. That's why I am using 10B pencil for that. At the same time, I have to leave this gap here. Here I am applying pressure over 10B to bring that much darkness. Here I am applying pencil 8B. Again, I am using PNB pencil here. Just to give some darker shade tones. This is approximately almost 90% of the upper part of this onion. Now I am using pencil 8B towards the lower part of this onion. Now, in this lighter area, for creating this kind of effect, I am using pencil 3B. Here again I am using 8B pencil to create this darker patch. I am creating darker lines. Again, I am using pencil 3B to make it finer. Here I'm using kneaded eraser to create such kind of effect. I'm not doing as it is, this kind of effect. Making it little bit lighter. I am creating this effect. I am zooming in. I'm using sharp pencil. Somewhat effect I'm giving it, not exactly as it is. Now I will use extreme sharp 10B pencil to bring depth into it by creating dark spot. Now we'll start rendering its upper part. First I will give it the shading with the use of pencil 3B. Now I'll use pencil 10B. Again 8B. Little bit tonal matching. Now it's shadow part. Now I will use pencil 3B to create a shadow. I am going to tilt this drawing because this kind of strokes will help me in blending it with the paper white. I am using extreme light pencil to blend it with the paper white because this is a soft shadow, not a hard shadow. Now this is almost shadow done. I will apply some finishing touches to this. I'll correct some shape. Now I'll apply some little brush, not with the purpose of smudging, but make it some finer touches. Light touch, don't never use it heavily with any kind of pressure. And it should not disturb its texture of the pencil. It should be there. Don't use it for doing darker tones. If you want to make it darker, apply pencil. Again, brush. Again 3B. Some lining I'm applying to give the effect of its natural texture, original texture of the onion. I'm applying little bead brush in the shadow part as well to fill those empty spaces. The pencil I am using is 3B right now. just to merge it with paper white. This is the property of soft shadow. So friend, this is the complete rendering. I have completed it for the onion. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial of how to render an onion right from the how to draw. Okay, I have shown some finer details as well, how you can bring the effect of some light waves, lighter dark lines, as well as the of the finer shell. Its bill, fineness of its bill, sharpness of its bill. So thank you so much. We'll see you in our next tutorial.